Dependency injection in C# using Unity framework part 2. In this part we will learn the dependency injection through method and property. Here DI by property and method. In previous block, because this is the part 2, in previous block we learned about constructor injection. Here we will learn about property injection and method injection using Unity container. Now let's start with the property injection. Property injection is a type of dependency injection where dependencies are provided through property. Let's understand how we can perform property injection using Unity container. We take previous blog example, employee registration system. So this is our employee class, this is our Unity container. This employee class requires the object of IDL data access layer. Unity container contains the data access, employee, email, billing and print. Then Unity container provide the dependent object, means data access layer, and all other objects that required by this client through this container. Let's move to the real example. This is our previous blog example, and in this example, if we will see here, we have created one class that is called the employee class, and this is the constructor of employee class. Here we are injecting the object of IUnity locator in the constructor, and then employee class contains one method that is called the addEmployee method. In program class, we have declared the IUnity container variable, then instantiate the Unity container, and then container.register type means the register all the classes with their the abstract layer, like as the IDL, SQL Server Data Access Layer, IEmail, email, and all these. Then we have resolved the employee class object, means we have created the employee class object through the Unity container. So here, let's come in employee class and comment all these lines. As region comment constructor injection, now we will create only one method in this class for this is commented line, and we will create a method that is called the addEmployee. Now, as I say that the property injection is a type of dependency injection where dependencies are provided through properties. It means we will create a property of dependent object. So let's we create a property. Here write prop, then IDL, and this is the data access layer. Now go to here, write prop, then IEmail, email. Now create a third property, and this is the IBilling, and this is billing. Now create the fourth property, and this is IPrint. So we have created all the properties. Now, for property injection, we tell the Unity container which property to inject. So we need to decorate the dependent properties with dependency attribute. So here we will decorate this with the dependency 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 and Unity attribute. So here just see here in this property we have only decorated the dependency for data access layer and call your data access layer dot register employee. You will also call all those methods, send email, billing dot bill to employee, then print dot print status. Now come to the program class. This is your UI layer and this layer also describe the iUnity. There is nothing to change in your Unity container. You are not using the iUnity locator, so that we will just comment this line and now run your program. You are running your program. It's building. Let's here you can see that this Unity container injects the dependent object in the property of the employee. So we'll create employee object through the Unity container. You can see here only the data access layer containing the dependent object of the SQL server data access. Billing is null, email is null, print is null. Why this is null? This is null because we did not decorate our email, billing and print property through the dependency. Let's decorate these property through the dependency. And run our program again. Go to the program class. Just start your program. Let's expand it. Yes, you can see that the billing property of employee also contains the object of billing class. Data access contains the SQL server data access, email, and these objects are injected by the Unity container. So you have created a class. Now go to inside of this and press F5. All these methods are executed successfully. Now your control is on the line number 15 on the debugger, and whenever you will press the F5, this will run perfectly. This is called the dependency through properties. Only one change, you need to change only one thing, that you will create a property instead of creating the constructor, and you must have to decorate that property through the one attribute called the dependency. So this is the way that you can inject your dependent object in a property. Now we will discuss the another way, that is called the method. So here just comment all these lines again. Now right? This is the property injection. Now you will create only one method. Yeah, this is the addImply. So method injection, we need to tell the Unity container which method should be used for dependency injection. So we need to decorate method with the attribute called the injection method. So this is our method that we would like to call from the client side, means from the program class. So come to here and create one public method, public wired dependency method. This is your dependency method. Now you will inject IDAL data access, IEmail, email, IBilling, billing, and IPrint, print. You will create four private variable here. So IDAL, DAL, IEmail, email, IBilling, billing, IPrint, print. So you will assign this dot DAL is equal to data access layer, this dot email equal to email, this dot billing equal to billing, this dot print equal to print. So this is a method in class imply, and I say that this method we need to tell the Unity container that this method is used for injecting the dependency. So we must have to attribute this method by injection method. Now there is nothing to change in your Unity container side, only change your calling side, and here in imply class you will change, and you can see that this dot DAL dot register employee, this dot email dot send mail, this dot billing dot bill to, and this dot print dot print status. Now we have injected all the dependent object through the dependency method. This is the name. You can change the method name according to your requirement, and we you must have to tell the Unity container that you would like to inject all the dependent object in imply class through this method. So you must have to attribute this method by injection injection method. Come to the program class. Nothing to change, just start your program class. And whenever the Unity container, yes, right. Unity container, now call this method because you have decorated this method as the injection method. And Unity container call dependency method and inject all the dependent object in dependency method. Now check this, all the object are injected in their variable. Now press F5. Yes, this is executed successfully. Now this is at the last line number 76. Control is on the line number 76. It means all the operation has been executed successfully. So this is the dependency injection through methods. Thank you for watching my video.